In the process of gene expression, we have done the first event, transcription. We have done that as a result of transcription, RNA or the ribonucleic acid, which are single chain polynucleotides, these are formed in the nucleus. These are the carrier of genetic information. Information for the formation of the protein. All RNAs, they are single chain. There are different type of RNAs. These RNAs are rRNA, tRNA, mRNA, genomic RNA, small nuclear RNA, small cytoplasmic RNA. There are different type of RNAs, but all type of RNAs are formed in the nucleus only. In the process of protein synthesis, we are mainly concerned about these three types of RNAs. I said all different type of RNA, they are single chain only, single stranded only. Sometimes we may come across double stranded RNA as in case of some virus. But these double stranded, these are also formed by folding of single strand only. So ultimately all are single stranded RNA. So now let us study these three different types of RNA. Let us first of all study rRNA. rRNA, tRNA and mRNA. These are the three types which are involved in the protein formation. R is ribosomal. This is transfer. And this is messenger. rRNA, these are the most common type of RNA. Around 70 to 80% of total RNA are rRNA. And there are different type of RNA. And some of them are longest also. As the name is indicating, R, ribosomal, these form component of ribosomes. What actually these are doing in the protein synthesis, or what are their functions? Functions of rRNA. Just now I said that these are the constituent of ribosome. Along with the proteins, they form the folding and the structure ribosome. So the first function is this only, that they are the component of ribosome, or you can say the site for protein formation or the site of translation. And due to this only, these are providing the binding site for tRNA, as well as these are providing the binding site to mRNA. Binding site for mRNA. Now the next come. tRNA, transfer RNA, the second common type of RNA. Around 15% of RNA are tRNA. These are smallest RNA. Why these are called transfer? Because they recognize the coding on the mRNA and transfer one by one amino acid accordingly. It is because of this function, these were called adapter molecule. by Watson. Watson, they described tRNA as the adapter molecule. We know that out of 64 codon, 61 are actually coding for amino acid and 3 are stop codon. So for these 3 stop codon, there is no tRNA for them. So at least there should be 61 type of tRNA for 61 codon, and the first one, which is coding for the AUG initiating codon, is called the initiator tRNA. But we are having around 100 type of tRNA in the cytoplasm. So why 100 type of tRNA in the cytoplasm? Because for some co-amino acid, there can be 2 to 6 different type of tRNA. So that is why we are having 100 type of tRNA. tRNA, they are playing very important role, and their structure is also adapted accordingly. So now let us study the structure of tRNA. These are the 2 different views of tRNA structure. This is called the clove leaf structure. This is clove leaf structure, and this is the L-shaped structure. Whether it is a clove leaf structure or it is L-shaped structure, you can notice loops in this. And 2N, 3-N, and 5-N. Similarly, there also 3-N and 5-N. Each loop is playing a very important role here. There, this site or this loop is for the anticodon binding site. There are anticodon here. You know that there is mRNA below this. This mRNA is having the coded language. Suppose here it is AUG. Then corresponding anticodon on this will be UAC. So this is for anticodon. So this is the anticodon site. Corresponding to this anticodon, there will be a specific amino acid here. Similarly, in L shape here, and this is the anticodon site. So I think this is quite clear in this structure, that there are 2 recognizing sites. On one side, this is recognizing the codon. On another side, this is recognizing the amino acid, and that is why this is the adapter molecule. Another loop that can you notice here is this one. This is ribosomal binding site. So by this, it is going to bind with the ribosome. And that this one or the this one, these are for the enzyme. That enzyme is amino acyl synthetase. Actually, amino acid is recognized by this. So it will bind with this enzyme first. So accordingly, now the amino acid will come and bind here. And at 5', there is G base here. Right? So whether you draw it in the L shape or whether you are drawing the clove leaf structure, all loops are like this. Now we move to the 3rd type of RNA, that is the messenger RNA. Messenger RNA, these are 5% of the total RNA, though these are long, and actually these are carrying the coded language. In prokaryote, directly mRNA is transcripted, but in eukaryote, it is first transcripted as hnRNA, and after the processing, this hnRNA is converted into mRNA. And we have done that mRNA is having a structure like this. This is having a cistron. And we have done this cistron can be monocistron. Monocistron, these are mostly found in eukaryotes. And polycistron. Polycistron, these are mostly found in prokaryotes. We have also done that this cistron is having initiating codon here and terminating codon here. Beside initiating and terminating codon, we have seen that there is capping. This capping is nothing but methylated guanosine triphosphate, and then there is tailing. This tailing is poly A tail. And what is the role of this capping and tailing? This also we have done in the video of processing, that this capping and tailing, these are important for protecting this mRNA from the action of nucleases. Otherwise, nucleases enzyme, they are going to break this mRNA. So now translation process couldn't be carried out. So that is why capping and tailing is done here. So is that clear? That rRNA is actually the site on which this mRNA will come and fit, tRNA and come and fit, and then the process of translation would be carried out. So in our next video, we'll see the process of transcription.